A Trojan horse for socialism. That is what Republican Paul Gosar and some of his colleagues called President Biden's COVID relief plan. They voted against it, and yet months later, they are singing a different tune. John Avlon is here with today's reality check.
Paul Gosar is at it again. No, not threatening AOC or calling members of the FBI and DOJ traitors or boycotting speeches by the Pope. Now, this is a different sin of blatant hypocrisy. You see, Gosar's doing a victory lap for delivering federal cash to his constituency, specifically COVID-19 relief funds that will be used to clean and provide relief for the Kingman, Arizona airport. In a press release, Gosar called it critical funding, essential to maintaining safe and reliable air service to the community. What he failed to mention is that he'd voted against the legislation that made it possible, the American Rescue Plan Act. In fact, he slammed it, saying, this bill's not about COVID relief. It's about funding Democrats' pet projects. The American people should be furious. And calling it a Democratic spending bonanza. Well, which is it, Congressman? A socialist spending scheme for or critical funding? But Gosar understands that he can vote no and still score the dough. And he's far from the only congressman to take credit for a bill that he tried to kill. Take Alabama Congressman Gary Palmer. Republican Freedom Caucus member who voted against the bipartisan infrastructure bill, called it recklessly expensive, and then promptly put out a press release touting its benefits back home, saying, funding the Northern Beltline has consistently been one of my top priorities. It will benefit the entire region and enhance economic development and employment opportunities. These are only a few blatant, grating examples of this. I could add other sworn enemies of bipartisanship, like North Carolina's Madison Cawthorn, Indiana's Greg Pence, or their leader, California's Kevin McCarthy. After all, not a single Republican voted for Biden's American Rescue Plan. Only 13 House Republicans voted for the bipartisan infrastructure bill, and they caught massive flack for it from their colleagues. I mean, you might have thought they voted to investigate an insurrection. Look, I know cynicism passes for wisdom in Washington for a reason, but this is ridiculous. And yet, it's the way we live now. Kentucky Democratic Congressman John Yarmuth didn't need much of a crystal ball when he predicted all this back in March.
What we're all concerned about on our side is the Republicans are all going to vote against this, and then they're going to show up at every ribbon cutting for every project that's funded out of this bill, and they're going to pump up their chests and take credit for all of these great benefits that are coming to their citizens.
And the reason he could predict all this is because we've seen it before. Like during the Obama years, when Republicans pursued a strategy of total obstruction during the fiscal crisis. And yet, one year after the passage of the Recovery Act, 70% of the House GOP had taken credit for some kind of improvement in their home district, prompting Washington Monthly to call them highway hypocrites. But this is more than mere partisan hypocrisy. It's part of the zero-sum game that stops people in Congress from reasoning together in good faith. Republicans, after all, only seem to care about deficits and debt when a Democrat is president. They attack popular social spending bills as socialism run amok, and then turn around and take a victory lap at home when the money starts flowing in. It should not be too much to expect some constancy. If a bill benefits your constituents consistent with your principles, vote for it. There will always be trade-offs, folks. Perfect's never on the menu. But if you demonize a bill, then you can't credibly turn around and take credit for it. At least not without getting called out. And that's your reality check.
Remember in high school, Avlon, and you would have a group project, and of course there's someone who does all the work, and then there's someone who does none of the work, but they all get the credit.
That guy. Yeah.
That guy.
We all remember that guy.
Ugh, yes. All right, John, thanks.
Take care.